Pandailah Hakim. Hakim ke
nama dia? 1.05. Betul-betul Hakim. Lepas tu dah dapat proses area tu darab lah dengan yang doktor cakap tadi. Dia punya velometric, dia punya wind speed.
Bagus.
So wind speed tadi kan 4 meter per second. So darab dapat volumetric flow rate, air volumetric flow rate.
Wind speed okay.
At the end of the day, you kali-kali-kali tu you dapat unit apa? Itu je cari nak tengok betul ke tak calculation, you always look for unit. Cuba tengok unit you cantik tak? Apa unit you? Cuba tengok.
Meter cube per second.
Meter
cube per second.
Betul. That's how we do. For me. Okay.
Syam, suruh kau explain balik ini.
Okay.
Alamak.
So,
okay, tadi Art dah faham kan?
If you get meter, meter cube per second, betul lah tu jawapan you, okay?
Susun piasa.
Okay, can we move to the concentration or some of you still need, you know, some assistance?
Doctor.
Yeah.
The Shams need explanation in English.
Yeah. Shams need.
Malay? Shams needs explanation in English.
Okay.
Is it possible to explain English? Sorry.
Oh, sorry, sir. Okay, because just now you didn't appear at all, so I thought you did not attend the class.
No, I was there.
You should say so from the beginning. Okay, so now I don't know. Dari mana nak start ni? From where?
From the start.
Cannot. You should tell me from the beginning. I didn't notice that you are in the. I thought you didn't come, you know, because I was waiting. Why you didn't?
We were there from the beginning.
Why you didn't raise up the issue?
No, I understood the previous part, but this one I didn't understand.
Okay, the previous part you understand?
Yeah.
Actually, I'm waiting for you to come out and tell me that. But I thought you are not attending the class because you just keep quiet, right? So I thought you are not attending.
No, we were attending. Me and Mehdi, both of us are there.
You should tell.
Ayo.
It's okay.
Okay, so this one you understand? The Q part you don't understand?
Yes.
Okay, first, collect the floor area data from table 5 in the paper.
Okay,
you have the table, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, in that table, you can see the flow area data for distillation, CSTR, and compressor.
Mm-hmm.
Collect that and then add it because you only have those 3 units in the process. So you have to add all the flow area for these 3 units. Okay?
Okay. So all of them, we have to add it, right?
Yeah. And then if you add, the total flow area for these 3 units should be 406.
Okay.
You can get it? You want to try now?
Yes.
Okay. And then we assume the floor area of the unit is in square shape.
Okay.
Therefore, to get the width of the edge of the area, you just have to find the square root of the value.
Square root of 406?
Yeah, because you assume the area as square shape.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so can you now calculate the 406, square root of the 406?
It's 20.14.
Very good, very good. Now we calculate the vertical area of the process. You have to multiply the edge width with the height of the process. And if you from the...
Height, the value of height will be from where?
Table 5,
means we have to multiply the height with the width?
Yes, width, just now you gave 20.15, right?
Yes.
Okay, the height in the journal paper, from what I asked you to read, is always to be 7 meter for petrochemical.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you multiply, tell me how much the value.
It's 141.04. That's 141 meters square.
Okay. Now, to get the volumetric airflow rate, multiply the vertical area with the wind speed. Assume wind speed is 4 meters per second.
Okay.
How much is the volumetric airflow rate? Multiply the vertical area with the wind speed.
564.
Yeah.
172.
Yes, correct. Now you get it?
Yes.
Okay. Can we proceed?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, good. Right,
thank you.
Okay, very sorry. What about
it's okay.
What about the earlier part? Did you really understand?
Yeah, I understood. Oh,
don't make me repeat that one. I cannot.
No, I understood that one.
Okay. Okay, next we go to the concentration. All right, guys? Sedikit lagi. At 1 o'clock, we stop.
All right.
Okay, now tell me, what is the formula to calculate the concentration?
Concentration
equals to
m over q.
What?
The fugitive emission rate divided
by the volumetric flow rate. Eh? Very good. Using this formula, you will get your chemical concentration in what unit? Concentration
kg per meter cube.
Betul. Kg per meter cube ataupun yang paling senang adalah mass over volume lah. Yeah?
Yes.
Alright. Let's do this. Betul. Tapi kita punya unit of interest for industrial hygiene, dia bukan unit ni. Yeah, for industrial hygiene punya purpose, unit of interest is always ada dua je. Apa untuk chemical? For chemical. Ada two unit.
PPI.
PPM.
PPM and?
PPM dengan
PPB.
No. I mean that one okay, PPM. Tapi satu lagi adalah we always interested in milligram per meter cube. Remember if you look at the CLV table? Betul tak? CLV table. Kan dia bagi you value in milligram per meter cube or PPM, right?
Yes.
Two unit only we interested. There's no kilogram per meter cube in TLV table. Okay? So in this case, we will first calculate the chemical concentration for hydrochloric acid, methanol, metacrolin in milligram per meter cube unit. Can you calculate for me now? Because you have all the data already.
Okay.
Boleh? Kita buat lah.
Okay, Doktor.
Alright. Who get the answer already? Tell me, ya. Okay, berapa concentration HCl, berapa concentration methanol? Apa jawapan you all?
Saya pun tengah kira. Sekejap, doktor. Tengah mengkira.
Saya pun tengah
kira. Tasha dah siap. Tasha dah siap, doktor.
Okey, cantik. Saya pun tengah kira. Saya pun dah. Okey, berapa?
Oh, Tasha
ID apa?
Concentration hydrochloric acid in milligram per meter cube. How much?
0.5726.
0.573 boleh?
Yeah. Boleh. Milligram per meter cube.
Okay. Colin?
Zero.
Pandai. Okay. Now, in order to for us to calculate the health risk, apa formula nak kira health risk? Yeah. Tell me first, apa formula nak kira health risk?
Health risk.
Yeah. Ah ni, saya ada bagi dekat slide ni. Apa unit health risk? Senang tak? Macam ni lah. Terus unit dia apa? Macam ni. Apa unit health risk?
Dalam ni tak tulis lah je.
The unit.
Apa? Saya macam terdengar jawapan.
Tak ada unit, koefisien ke?
Pandai. Unitless. Very good.
Dimension. Unitless.
Pandai. Kalau unitless, maknanya apa? Nilai yang diperhatikan tu mempunyai nilai unit yang
sama.
Sama. That's why you boleh kata. Betul tak? Okay. In order to kira health risk, you mesti sentiasa membandingkan concentration chemical dalam plant you terhadap terhadap apa?
Exposure
limit.
Terhadap standard.
Limit.
Terhadap exposure. Pandai terhadap limit. So
terhadap TLV.
Yeah. So dalam kes ni, you boleh tahulah formula untuk kira health risk. Sama dah. Bahagi apa?
Concentration over TLV, macam tu.
Concentration of?
Concentration of chemical.
Chemical bahagi?
Bahagi TLV.
Concentration TLV value. Bagus. Yeah? Bagus sangat. Very good. Tapi unitnya kena sama.
Sama.
Dalam kes ni,
PPM.
Saya bagi kamu unit DLV unit apa?
PPM.
PPM. So nak tak nak kamu kena tukar consolation kamu ke dalam unit?
PPM.
PPM. So kita pergilah slide yang sebelumnya. Unit of interest dalam kes ni kamu berminat dengan unit?
PPM.
PPM. Macam mana nak convert kamu punya concentration yang daripada unit miligram per meter cube tadi ke concentration dalam unit ppm?
Macam mana? Bagi 1000 kot. Bagi 1000.
Satu gram per meter cube sama dengan 1 ppm.
Boleh bagi formula tak? Apa akannya data kita perlukan? Data baru.
Conversion.
Yeah, conversion kita perlukan chemical punya molecular weight.
Molecular weight.
So formula dia kan, saya tulis kat sini. Formula dia adalah C ini adalah sama dengan chemical kamu punya concentration dalam unit asal kali 24.45. Macam mana dapat 24.45 ni? Panjang dia punya story. Kerana kita assume STP kan, 1 atmosfera 25 degree Celsius, ada lah bla 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 bla, akhirnya dapat 24.45, okey. Dan kesemua ini bahagikan dengan molecular weight value. Boleh?
Okay,
cuba korang kira, apakah concentration bagi hydrochloric acid dan methanol dalam ppm? Kalau you tak buat ni, you tak boleh sama. Kalau saya bebe pun, you tak boleh faham. Saya so, tak buat dengan tangan you. Memang macam tu, matematik memang macam
bahagi dengan molar weight. Set ni molar weight benda apa? Molar weight HCl 6.5.
Berapa nilai PPM HCl?
HCl
384
PPM.
384 betul. Nanti. Untuk metanol?
Bagus.
Metanol
0.02.
Betul. 2 1. Okay, now let's calculate half risk untuk hydrochloric acid dulu. Berapa nilai half risk dia?
0.384.
0.0766.
0.0766. Betul. 0.0768, 0.07 macam tu ya?
0.0768.
Yes, untuk metanol?
Allah kecil. 0.00025.
Ini sikit sangat ni.
Betul. 0.0025. 3 kali 0.
0.0025.
Okey. 25. Apa yang selalu sangat budak buat dalam exam ke apa, dia tertukar antara nilai molecular weight dengan TLV.
Oh.
Ni makanlah dulu.
Orang kaya sangat orang tengok dekat jadual tu, korang tak perasan kan? So you pergi pakai pakai molecular weight terbalik-terbalik, itu memang banyak kesalahan. Tolong jangan macam tu ya. Okay, so untuk kita last kali bila jawapan kita mesti kena characterize. Itu nombor je. Eh, nombor untuk industrial hygiene, hygienist kita faham lah nombor tu. Tapi untuk awak sampaikan kepada plan manager, kepada masyarakat, you kena cakap dalam layman word. So kesimpulannya sekali you kena tutup dengan risk characterization. Kesimpulannya apa you boleh assume untuk plan ni, proses you ni, risiko exposure risk pekerja kepada hydrochloric acid dianggap acceptable ke not acceptable? Risky ke
acceptable.
Tak?
Acceptable.
Acceptable kerana nilai risk
risknya ada rendah.
Less than one.
Less than one.
Oh, less than one.
Yeah. Very, very less.
Yes. Sama dengan methanol juga. Yeah. So, kalau dalam dalam whatever assessment ke, kalau saya tanya, tu kena jawab macam tu kerana less than one, acceptable. Macam tu, ya. Okay. Itu adalah untuk individual chemical. Tapi, like I told you, in chemical plant, kita tak pernah hidup dengan satu chemical je. Dia mesti mixture of chemical. Betul tak?
Betul.
So untuk kira
betul
of exposure to chemical mixture dalam kes ni macam mana? Nah, sikit je lagi.
Tambah.
Oh je.
Yes, kena tambah apa dan apa?
Total up ni.
Apa tambah apa?
Total up the concentration.
Dia punya health bukan. Dia punya
tenang sangat dah last ni. Dah tak ada apa-apa dah. No more extra work.
PPM tadi tu tambah dua-dua.
Jangan HCL yang dengan mental. Kalau kamu tambah yang tu, kamu nak bahagi dengan TLV mana? Betul tak?
Oh.
Tambah health risk tu.
Tambah
health risk.
Bahagi.
Pandai.
Dia nak kena
bahagi.
Saya bagi.
Tak payah.
Dia tambah je.
Canggih. Tambah je yang health risk 0.0768.
Dengan 0.0000 dulu.
Tampun dengan 0.0000025 tadi.
Oh.
Itu akan bagi half risk for the mixture. Akan remember harus kumpulan mana yang present on toxicology tu? Kumpulan mana? Ingat tak? Remember they said chemical mixture may exhibit different type of tindak balas of reaction. One of them is synergetic. Yang additive effect. This one we assume additive effect. Because in the mixture acting one another in an additive way. So with this assumption, you are allowed to just add the individual half risk to get the half risk for the mixture. Okay? After you have total up, you check again against one. If it is still below one, so the risk of exposure among workers to the chemicals mixture in the process is acceptable ataupun tak. You still have to make that. Okay. Alright. I thought we can finish until PNID. Nampaknya we cannot. Today only PNID.
Yeah. 3 hours.
PNID pun dah
saya. Okay, we have to end ni sebab nanti lama sangat. So betul tak total of the health risk for the mixture 0.0774 ya? Tutup wassalamun. Okay, let me do some announcement. First, this video if okay, everything turn out well. Because I have recorded it, I will cut it into smaller length of video and I will upload it in the YouTube.
Okay.
YouTube channel.
Viral, viral, viral.
Viral. Kau ala-ala artis kan dapat duit ke? Ha? So nanti I will give you the link in the e-learning. In the I will give you the link then you can watch back if you want to do revision. Okay?
Okay, the
computer ni nama rekod lah, kalau tidak aduh aku tak tahu lah. Yeah. Okay, then number two announcement. I hope everybody has signed in for the attendance.
Sudah.
And number three, next week we will continue like this for detail PFD and PNID. But things will get so much easier because dia hanya tambah sikit, only slightly modification from what we learn today.
Okay.
So, it will be the most tiring lah because first time you encounter all this kan. Okay, fourth announcement, this one you have to listen. All this calculation, write back nicely, beautifully, make a copy for you and scan it, send to me as homework number one.
Okay.
Only copy back because I want to make sure you study back, you have proper nicely, good for you and good for me. At least I can give you some mark as homework. Okay. Just copy back je, not a new question pun, okay?
Right.
And last but not least, about our video assignment, you all understand, right? I will share you the announcement on the video today. Maybe we look together now, can I?
Macam mana?
Okay, sekejap je because I want to show you how, yeah. Okay, how to share, okay, a file. Let me go Google Drive. Sekejap je, all right. Okay, boleh. Can you see the word file?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, read now. Ataupun tak apalah, dah nak habis masa lah. Saya takut nanti video ni terpotong. You read. I will share also in the e-learning and then we discuss in WhatsApp, eh?
Okay.
Before I end, do you have anything to ask me about today's lesson?
So far, clear.
So far, so good, huh?
Saya akan tanya Ash lah kalau saya tak faham.
Apa dia?
Tak ada apa.
Also for your test, don't worry, I have made the question, but you can open all the notes for the test, yeah?
Okay, doctor.
Only I want you to know why, more justification lah for the, because we don't have choice lah, kita kena buat test macam ni kan, so I kena tanya soalan yang more on your thinking lah, yeah? Okay. Don't worry too much lah, yeah? So you prefer next week or you prefer next week fugitive emission sama? Okay, let's finish the class first, then only the test, yeah?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, till then, thank you very much.
Bye-bye, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Jangan lupa breakfast, lunch.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.